Radio St. Louis presents The Metro Show, a weekly program devoted to charitable organizations in the St. Louis area.
Welcome to The Metro Show. My name is Trish Gazall, and this is where we talk about things going on in the community as you coming up. But today we're going to focus on an outstanding member of our community, and she's a teen, and we just thought this is such a dynamic person who's really trying to do stuff in the community that we need to put a little spotlight on her. This is how it came about. You know, we have our Bikes for Tykes donation 36-hour bike drive coming up next week. And we received an email from a mom, her name's Amanda, who said, hey, my daughter would love to come and volunteer for a couple of hours and just be involved. And, you know, we don't get that often where individuals are just saying, hey, I would love to, you know, get involved, especially from teenagers. So we thought, wow, let's look into this a little bit, and come to find out she has a whole website and a program and a lot of stuff going on. And you're 14, is that
yes,
right?
Yes, I am 14 years old.
I should probably say your name, Abbie Mueller, 14 years old. And, you know, I talked about Bikes for Tykes briefly, but it sounds like you try to get involved in a lot of things going on in the community. So what made you kind of, or your mom, write that email and tell us a little bit about you, how you wanted to be involved in this?
Well, I've always loved doing community service. I have many organizations. I have a charity called Abby's Helping Hands, or I make blankets and blessing bags for kids in crisis. I go and I cook at the Ronald McDonald House. And so when I heard about Bikes for Tykes, I automatically knew that I wanted to jump in. Any service opportunity that I can get involved with, I go right for. And so when I heard about Bikes for Tykes, I said, Mom, you got to email them because I would love to volunteer.
And she's 14, everyone. She just makes blankets and cooks food and wants to give up her time. Now, I mean, a lot of people have to do it for high school credit. Is this just on your own?
And yes. I mean, does it help with high school credit? Yes. But really, it's I enjoy doing it on my own. I did it before high school. I did it in eighth grade and middle school before it even counted. So really, this is something that I just love doing.
Do you want to give a shout out to your high school while we're here?
Hey, Whitfield,
hey. We used to play them in field hockey. I mean, this is a long time ago. I went to Ursuline, but they always won. So we won't talk about that anymore. Sore subject. But Abbie, all right, let's get back to your community service that you've been doing. Because you actually have a website and a program.
Yes.
So tell us what the website is and about the program.
So my website is www.selfvalyou.org. Self-ValYOU is a mentoring program that I started based off of a personal experience. It teaches people about the importance of positive body image. This is something that I struggle with. I struggled with my weight when I was younger, and I would hear people in the locker room. This is an experience I had. They would call themselves fat, and then other people would come in and they would say that they weren't, and they were seeking for validation. And when I realized that I did the same thing, and it had really impacted me because I was also really struggling with my weight, and this girl wasn't who had said this, but when I realized that this is something that I did, I knew that I wanted to make a change.
First of all, for, you know, you're 14. So when you say when I was younger, the fact that you guys are even thinking about this just kind of hurts my heart at this point, you know. But I mean, we see it everywhere. The images they portray in the media, on TV, on Instagram.
It's very common in kids my age as well. It's one of the kind of primest ages where body image is kind of formed, especially with people who are changing at different rates. And, you know, it's scientifically proven that when people are changing, when they feel that they're not changing at the same rates as other people, it makes them feel like they're doing something wrong. So it changes their body image and how they feel about themselves.
Okay, the website again is selfvalyou.org. It's
yes.
Self, VALYOU.org. So tell us, you know, how do people get involved in this program you started and what exactly it is?
So the program itself, it is a presentation I actually just presented about 2 weeks ago, and I use road signs. The road signs stand for different ways that you can turn negative body image thoughts into positive self thoughts. And so using those road signs, I have different presentation skills. I give the presentation to all different ages, and I enjoy doing this because really it's something that I like touching, not that sounds weird, but I like inspiring people in a way where I had a little girl come up to me and she said that my program had inspired her because she was struggling with that herself. And, you know, it's so common, and it's something that everybody struggles with no matter how old you are. And so the program itself, using in kind of no matter what your gender, your age, or anything like that, the road signs are something that everybody uses.
Okay, give us an example of a road sign.
Right, so the Y and YOU, that's what I use for the road signs, is a fork in the road. And you ask yourself, why are you feeling like this? Are you really mad at your body or your self-image or who you are as a person, or are you frustrated about something else? So you could choose to go to a different direction or a more positive thought. You could go on the negative side or the positive one, the fork in the road.
Obviously, you're encouraging to go to the positive.
Of course.
Yes.
I would hope so.
Did you come up with this by yourself?
Well, yes. It took so long because, really, body image is such a broad topic. And so finding a way to make a program that was accessible for all ages, all genders, was difficult. You know, something that was for people who were younger, you know, you can't just say this is body image and this is why it's affecting you in a bad way. That would not reach them.
Yeah, they just
they would not be
yet
able to engage with that. But maybe saying that for an adult might engage with them more, but I had to have an equal balance. Road signs, you know, even if you don't drive, you see road signs every day and you could automatically connect with, you know, why am I feeling like this? You could go the other direction. I use U-turn, turn your negative thought, turn it around to a positive. Everybody can connect with that no matter how old you are.
I would just like to remind everyone she's 14. I mean, seriously. Her name's Abbie Mueller. I think this this young lady is going places and trying to make an impact on our community and especially young girls. So how do people become aware of this program and or get involved? Are you reaching out to schools and organizations to come speak, or are you reaching out to individuals, or both?
Right. Well, my mom and I, we have the first presentation I did that was not to my school. My brother's friend, his mom, was working. She had a friend who went to a school that had a lot of girls who were struggling with their body image, and they when they had a group discussion, they were kind of talking about it. And she said, "Well, Abbie, my friend's daughter, she does this program that I think these girls would really benefit from." And so really that having that network and people that you know is such a helpful thing. And of course, you know, all my Instagram, social media platforms are so helpful to network and to really get myself out there so that people know, you know, I'm presenting. If you want to email me, I have an email account.
Well, let's give out your socials and
okay.
Your email.
So my Instagram is self-value, exactly how it's spelled, with the YOU in all caps. Same thing for Facebook. And then my Gmail is selfvalyou@gmail.com.
And it's self, VALYOU.
Yes.
Without the UE on the value.
Yes.
selfvalyou.org is the website.
Correct.
Or you can get involved through her social media account. So you're interactive on your social media.
Oh, yes, all the time. I have on my website, I have these blog posts that I'm constantly doing, whether it's about social media apps or I do these things called interviews with a YOU at the end, of course. And I interview different people who have inspired me or who have stories to tell where they have used in some form what my program is about to help overcome moments of negative body image. For instance, one of my very close friends, her mom, has been working on weight and really overcoming some life. I don't know. She's just been working on herself as a person for a very long time, and hearing her stories have always inspired me. And I thought that a lot of people would benefit from hearing her story. But when I was struggling with my weight, I did not know her, but, you know, I wish I would have, because her stories and her kind of outlook on life has inspired me, and I know inspires her daughter, and I know inspires my mom in many different ways. And so having these interviews out there on my website and on all my social media platforms, I've had people watch them and say that was so inspiring to hear that, and having those personal experiences out there, those people are so brave to share them, and you know how they overcame them is really what is so interesting to hear to me. So
we kind of talked about how you talked to a group through networking, but do you also speak at schools?
Oh yes, the one that I just presented a couple weeks ago was at a school. The first presentation I ever did of self-value was at my own school, and people loved it. I'm actually working on right now presenting to my school again to the younger grades, because I presented to people who were my age, but now I'd like to try to reach out to people who are younger, because I've tried out. Like I said, I've tried out people my age, but I'd like to see how younger people react to this, because I have not yet seen how they are inspired by the program, and I'd love to see that. I know that I presented to my brother as a practice, and, you know,
how'd he take it?
Well, I love you, Grant, but of course he made a couple jokes here and there when I tried to interact with him.
Well, that's what little brothers are for, right?
Yes, but, you know, he said that even though, you know, he's 11 years old and I'm his sister, so we can't take everything super seriously, he had a little bit of seriousness in his heart, and he said that he enjoyed it. And so having that kind of that person who is younger
and that feedback,
but still experiences that every day is really helpful.
It's so...
So use your siblings.
Right. Use your siblings as much as you can. I mean, again, it's just... I can't believe at that age, and you say even younger, that young women and girls are dealing with these issues.
You know, even boys, too. I mean, it's just something that everybody struggles with, especially when kids my age, like I said, I can't emphasize enough, when our bodies are changing, you know, we're not all changing at the same speeds. And like I said earlier, when we realize that we don't change at that same rate, we think we're doing something wrong. It's our fault.
And if you have people picking on you because of it.
And it's other people. It's your own mind saying that, you know, you're just not good enough. And it's not just about body, too. You know, it's about school. I used to be in a math class that I was really struggling with, and I would constantly, you know, put myself down because I wasn't getting a subject. And I then realized with, you know, not just this, that when I came up with these things, that using that was, it's not my fault. I'm not dumb because I'm not understanding a subject. Once I find something that I can connect with my everyday life to this subject, I will automatically understand it. You know, using these things that I've created are so helpful. You can apply them to all aspects of your life. I dance, and that is one of the most critical kind of things that you could do. Dancers are wanting to be the best that they can be. And sometimes that means that we can be a little bit hard on ourselves, especially when we're not getting, you know, a certain dance step right. But using this, just constantly telling yourself, I am good enough. I will not get it right now, but imagine how good I'll be, you know, an hour from now or a week from now, is what kind of gets you going.
This is Abbie Mueller. She's 14 and on her own has created this program to promote positive personal imagery. It says on her website, selfvalyou.org, selfvalyou.org. She's also on social media at SelfValYOU.
Yes.
And who, if anyone's out there listening, obviously people with young daughters or sisters, nieces, whatever. But who would you like to go to your website if you could, you know, speak to anyone right now? This is how I can help you.
You know, the great thing about the program is that it's accessible to everybody. That's why I did the road signs. It's something that everybody can connect with, even if I said, like I said, even if you can't drive. But really, anybody who thinks that they could benefit from it, who knows people who could benefit from it, because really, whether we know it or not, we all have those moments of self-doubt, and we all could use a way to overcome them or just flip them around to something positive. So anybody who would benefit from this, anybody who would think that anybody else could benefit from this, I would love to come and present. I would love to come and inspire you, because seeing the benefits of people who really connected with it are so rewarding, and that's what it's all about.
Yeah, anyone who wants to book Abbie, too, she's available for presentations. So what next after this?
After this, well, I'm planning on doing this for quite some time. I'm hoping that it grows into something huge. It's already on its way. But really, after this, I plan on moving to New York, being on Broadway. I would love to pursue musical theater as a career. But keeping this self-value, the program, and everything that it stands for, carrying that with me through life is a big goal of mine. And having that.
And it's needed.
It is this kind of program for
young girls.
You know, everybody talks about it, and everybody says that everybody has those moments, but nobody has really come up with a way to kind of tackle it and address it. And, you know, that's something I'm really proud of, when my mom and I sat down and thought, okay, how are we going to lay this out in a way that's interactive and people can connect with? you know, that's something that I'm very proud of, that I can come up with a way that everybody could connect with this, and that it's something that no matter how old you are, you can carry with you through life. And I know I use these steps every day in my life so that I don't have those moments of negativity, that I'm constantly being a positive person and I am carrying that positivity through all aspects of my life.
That's so awesome. So how long has this been up, like your website and the program?
The website has been up for about a month and a half, I would say.
Oh, so this is fairly new.
It is fairly new. We were playing the website. We did, you know, where how we wanted to put the blogs on, because I've been doing blogs for quite some time, but I didn't have a website where I could put them all on there.
Yeah, like all packaged together.
Right. Mm-hmm. And so whenever I got the website up, I said, this is what we got to do. This is where everything has to go, because everything that I've been doing has been going on my Facebook. But I wanted to have that place where everything was all on one place, where if you wanted me to come present, if you wanted to read my blog post, if you wanted to see an interview, it was all on one place. And you could read about my program, you could read about me, you could read about, you know, anything really, all in one place. And so I'm really proud of the website and I'm really proud of the program.
I am so glad you reached out. We love to put the spotlight on people doing extraordinary things, and I think this absolutely counts. Abbie Mueller, who's 14, has this program. Oh, and you have a competition coming up, don't you?
Yes, I am your Miss Fort Lee's Outstanding Teen. The Outstanding Teen organization is the teen version of the Miss America organization. I'll be competing in June to be your Miss Missouri's Outstanding Teen.
I'm not surprised. Good luck.
Thank you.
Her website, selfvalyou.org, selfvalyou.org. Also, SelfValYOU on Facebook, Instagram, all the social media platforms. Abbie Mueller, thank you so much for coming in this morning. We appreciate it, and happy holidays.
Thank you. You too.
And my next guest, in full disclosure, I do commercials for Goodwill, and I am